This is great news for Republicans. I mean, the state Senate recalls are a completely different ballgame, as you know, from a statewide election. It's individual local elections. And this is great news because 53% of Wisconsin, if they made this a referendum on Walker, they lost. And they lost
big time.
That's
correct. We all know Walker's wildly unpopular in Madison. Well,
guess no
what?
Kidding.
Every member of the state legislature from Madison is a Democrat. You're not going to punish anyone there. So what if he's wildly unpopular in Dane County? It's in the rest of the state where the legislature is chosen. And I think that this was just a resounding success for him. I don't think they're going to take out any state senators. I think that this was the beginning and the end of the left's backlash. They wanted to make a statement here that Scott Walker is incredibly unpopular. They had a Supreme Court justice whose reputation they trashed by trumping up a bunch of allegations. They lied about him. They lied about his independence. They threw all of this. They brought in money from all over the country. They pounded away, and the best they can do is come up with a virtual dead heat statewide in an election whose results were distorted by the fact that there was an unusually high voter turnout in Madison. I think that this is the end of it, and I think this is going to embolden the Republicans to press forward with their agenda because they see that the left doesn't have, you know, the voters in Wisconsin aren't unhappy. They're not mad. Other than Dane County, this was, I think, a statement of support.
I think it was.
Take out Milwaukee County, where all of the state senators from the county, Alberta Darling excluded, are Democratic, and you see that the rest of the state went really strongly for Prosser, which I think can be interpreted as a vote of support for Scott Walker. I want to share with the audience, Ted, a story that, even though I'm off, I'm working on, because when I learned of it from people who are contacting me, it just shocked me. The story comes from the city of Mequon, and I'm going to take a couple of minutes here to just walk through what happened and what the response that Mequon city officials are giving me. I was contacted by people who informed me about a young man, a college student, who lives, college students are allowed to vote either in the city that they're going to school or in their hometown. And he registered to vote, first-time voter, in Mequon, which is where his family is from and where he lives on school breaks and in the summer. He registered to vote several weeks ago and then requested an absentee ballot because he was going to be back at school yesterday on Election Day. He registered and was given an absentee ballot and turned it in and thought that that was the end of it. He was contacted in the interim by election officials who said that he needed to provide his driver's license number. I've never heard of that before. When you register to vote, they request certain information to verify who you are and where you are, including maybe some proof of where you live. But since he was accompanied by his father, who is somebody who can vouch for him, that's usually, in most areas, sufficient. Well, they contacted him and they said, no, you've got to turn in your driver's license number. The father showed up at the polling place, or actually at Mequon City Hall yesterday, with the kid's driver's license number so that the ballot could be accepted. And he was told that it's too late. We've already shredded his ballot. Shredded it. The ballot was shredded. The kid is nowhere near Mequon. He wasn't able to come back and vote. The father is livid. Now, I looked into this because it's clear to me that several improprieties occurred here, including, I think, a blatant violation of Wisconsin state law. First of all, the kid wasn't registered to vote by Acorn or some third-party group. He went into Mequon City Hall, and he was given his registration information by an employee of the Mequon City Clerk. If they felt he needed to provide more information, including his driver's license number, why did they give him a ballot and allow him to vote? So from his perspective, he must have thought that he was legitimate. Now, that's the first irregularity.
Yep.
Secondly, if indeed they've determined after the fact that in order for his registration to be valid, they've got to come in with a driver's license number, why not save the ballot? Wisconsin law is specific on this, and I think so is federal law. When there is a disputed ballot, it is to be set aside so that it can be challenged after the fact.
Yeah, it's a provisional ballot.
Yes. In this case, they shredded it. Now, I was astonished when I heard about this, so I immediately filed an open records request with the city of Mequon, and I thought I was being clever here. I filed an open records request for the shredded ballot. Given the fact that it wasn't a voted ballot, It is, therefore, a public record because it's a record that's in the hand of a government official. Ballots, obviously, are secret, but this was deemed by Mequon to be a non-ballot. So I literally requested the shredded ballot and said that I wanted the shards from the ballot, and then I requested every other piece of information with this. I also indicated to them that I was demanding that they immediately preserve all records, that nothing get thrown out today, including any ballot shreds, and I was prepared to seek a court injunction to enjoin them from throwing any of these things out, my fear that they would destroy the evidence of this young man's vote. I had a long conversation today with Lee Szymborski, who is, Szymborski. He is the city administrator and city clerk in the city of Mequon. He said to me that they made attempts over the last 3 weeks to contact the father and the young man and indicate that he needed to provide his driver's license number. I indicated, well, the father felt he was providing the driver's license number. He came in on election day and gave it. How would he possibly come to think that you would throw away the ballot? Why wouldn't he think that he could cast that ballot? The administrator says that the registration was not valid because it didn't have the driver's license number. Therefore, the original ballot was nullified. He acknowledged that the ballot should not have been shredded, but he said it was an honest error. He said that the error was made by an assistant clerk in Mequon. I have demanded to know the name of who that person is. So far, at least, they haven't provided it, but they do say that they'll work on a summary for me. So what happened here is, and the sad thing about this is that this was this young man's first election. We are in a state, Ted, where Acorn has been running around for the last several years in groups like it, registering every Tom, Dick, and Harry with every phony name imaginable. You've got people who are able to register at the polls, walking in with maybe a piece of paper that looks like it might be a lease, and people immediately give them ballots. But in this instance, a person not registered by a third party walks into City Hall of Mequon with his father, is given a ballot, believes he is voting in good faith, and has his ballot canceled, and doesn't have the ability to rectify it because he's gone, and the original ballot was shredded. Now, the red flag for me here is why they would have shredded the ballot. They didn't even just throw it away. They shredded it. Why not set it aside just in case there is an issue like this? So what you have now is, if this family wants to challenge the fact that the ballot was disqualified, there's no ballot to prove how he voted, and his vote couldn't be added to a vote total after the fact, even if a judge ordered that his vote should be counted. Now, I don't know if this is an honest error or if there's an employee of the Mequon clerk's office who is a belligerent public employee bent on stealing the election. I don't know. Szymborski, the city clerk, indicated to me he was offended at the suggestion, but after what I've seen over the last few weeks, I wouldn't put it past anyone. I can also tell you that it's been reported that Bob Spindle, who is the Republican designee on the Milwaukee City Election Commission, asked last night that police guard the ballots in the city of Milwaukee. He's concerned what city employees in Milwaukee could be doing to ballots. This is serious stuff, and it is a really tight election, and I think it's a disgrace that a young man who in good faith was trying to vote in the city of Mequon was denied the right to vote because of incompetent dunderheads in the city clerk's office up there. And a mere, well, it's an honest mistake and people make a mistake. For crying out loud, we're running an election here that the entire world is watching, and we're given an excuse that career lifers who get to retire in their mid-50s with a pension can't even figure out how to properly give advice to a person on voting and then take it upon themselves to destroy a ballot when the law is clear that any disputed ballot is to be saved so that it can be challenged after the fact. I don't know if anything can be done about this. I do have my open records request to get to the bottom of what happened, but I think the situation there is a travesty. Now, that's one case that I learned of in Mequon. We've been hearing stories about goofed-up things that happened all over the state. In the past, we've overlooked them because our elections, while tight, probably weren't in the range of a few hundred votes. I think there's a very real chance that the combination of mistakes and fraud in Wisconsin will be decisive in this election. in any event, that was what happened in Mequon, and my investigation of it. The deputy clerk in Mequon is a woman named Diane Kowalczyk. I did leave messages for her. She never got back to me. I also left messages for the city attorney of Mequon, John DeStefanis. But I did, as I say, speak to Szymborski, who is the city clerk and the city administrator. He said it was an honest error destroying the ballot, but he also says that the ballot never should have been accepted in the first place because this driver's license number should have been demanded. I can guarantee you, Ted, that there are thousands of people in Wisconsin who registered to vote with Acorn and other and city officials that didn't have to provide driver's license numbers. But we've got the people in Mequon making you jump through hoops in order to vote, whereas in Milwaukee, if you're breathing, they'll give you a ballot.
Absolutely. The question that I have is, if they destroyed one ballot, did they destroy any more?
They said no. Now, I was wondering if this meant that every other ballot that they felt was the result of an improper registration was destroyed. They say this is the only one. Now, I have no way of knowing if that's true, because you can't recover something that's been destroyed. They also told me that the ballot was actually shredded several days ago and maybe even a couple of weeks ago. It struck me as really odd. What was the rush to throw away this ballot? Do they run the tidiest city hall in America? What was the need to do that?
Oh, absolutely.
And I didn't get a good answer for that either, other than it was a mistake by an assistant clerk and it shouldn't have been done.
That's a remarkable story. And I feel terribly for this young man. I mean, it's your first election. I took my daughter to register, and she voted in the first election. And I'll tell you what, it's a wonderful day. And this poor kid, you know, who's doing what he wants to do and is obviously a student, suddenly gets his taken away from. It's remarkable.
Well, and his father's very upset, obviously. And they say, well, they did try to contact him and say, you need to come in with your driver's license. The father interpreted that as, okay, I'll come in on election day, provide him with his driver's license number so they can accept his ballot. He never had the impression that he needed to do this before the election, and that the ballot that his son had, remember, his son turned in the ballot. So if they thought there was a problem with it, why did they let him vote? He turned in the ballot, and they accepted it and decided after the fact that, oh, there's got to be a driver's license number down in here. And in the end, his vote ends up not being counted in what may go down as the closest statewide election in Wisconsin history.